Today, we'll be making Filipino Lumpia, which is a deep-fried spring roll that is guaranteed to make you the star of any party. But before we get started, do not forget to click that subscribe button and the notification bell next to it to get updated with the newest videos. My goal is to make Filipino food as accessible as possible. So today we're gonna be using these egg roll wrappers that I found at Ralph's, which is my local grocery store. Now they are not the standard lumpia wrappers that we normally use. However, they are what was available and they can still help you curb those lumpia cravings. Let's get started. Take about 2 cloves of garlic and crush them. In this recipe, I use a food processor to make my life easier. If you don't have a food processor, that's totally fine. Just make sure you finely mince all the ingredients so that they can incorporate well together as the filling. That said, take a medium onion and chop it up just a little bit so that it can mince nicely in the food processor. Next, take about 1/2 cup of carrots, or in this case, about 12 baby carrots. Finally, take 1/2 cup of cabbage. Here, I have a blend of green and purple cabbage, kale and Brussels sprouts. Typically, we use cabbage as the veggies, but you can use whatever you find in the fridge that cooks as easily as cabbage. So for example, the veggies I had were green beans and celery, and I could have used those. It would have been perfectly fine. Next, grab your food processor if you have one and throw in the garlic and onions. Blitz them up just until they've been minced, then follow up with the carrots. Give that a few pulses and then add the cabbage or whatever veggies you decided to use. Try not to overprocess so your filling doesn't turn to mush, but don't worry, your lumpia would still taste really good. Next, add 1.5 pounds of meat. I'm using ground turkey for a leaner lumpia, but you can use ground pork, ground beef, ground shrimp, ground chicken, whatever you choose. Personally, I really like the blend of ground pork and ground shrimp. That's how my grandma makes it. It's so good. Next, include a whole egg. It's optional if you don't have egg, by the way. And 1/2 teaspoon black pepper, 1 tablespoon of fish sauce. Now, the fish sauce makes a huge difference. Please try not to skip this part. And then 1 teaspoon of salt. Blend this all up, and then we're ready to wrap it up. Take one wrapper and place it on a flat surface so that you can see it as a diamond shape. Take about 2 tablespoonfuls of filling and lay it out diagonally across the wrapper, leaving about 1.5 inch spaces on the sides. Fold the bottom part of the wrapper on top of the filling and then tuck and tighten against the filling so that it's secure. Fold the sides towards the middle and then continue rolling upwards, keeping the wrap tight. Dab your fingers in some water and then apply that water at the edge of the wrap to secure the wrap. The wrapper should stick onto itself. Next, slice this in half to make 2 smaller lumpia, so it's easier to handle and easier to eat. If you do slice the lumpia in half, you do run the risk of having some filling pour out while you are frying. So it's up to you if you want to take that risk. You can just keep it whole. Continue wrapping the rest of the filling until you've used up all the wrappers or used up all the filling. Tip for leftover fillings, you can fry them up into patties and you can eat it with rice, or you can use it as a burger. Next, take a frying pot or pan of your choice and heat up about 2 cups of oil with a high smoke point. Make sure your flame is on medium high. Ideally, you'd want to choose a pot or a pan that can fully submerge the lumpia in the oil. Drop a little piece of the wrapper in the oil. If it starts to bubble and float, we're ready to fry. Fry only as much lumpia as you can without overcrowding the pan, which should only take about 1.5 to 2 minutes each side. Notice how the wrapper is bubbling up because this wrapper is thicker. Once the lumpia is ready, take them out and lay them on a paper towel lined bowl or plate. Serve these guys hot and fresh with a dipping sauce of your choosing. I love dipping lumpia in sweet chili sauce or banana ketchup, but I've also seen people dip it in vinegar. Wasn't that recipe super simple? I feel like once you get the wrapping technique down, everything else is a breeze. Well, I really hope that you guys enjoyed that video, and I hope that inspired you to make lumpia at home. Please do not forget to click that subscribe button and the notification bell next to it so that you can get notified of future videos. Thank you guys so much for your time, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!